Jim Prusha had to have the innate intelligence and vision of technology to see, even when it was just one station, which it was for a long time, that eventually all this stuff could be hooked together, and technically hooked together. And Martin and those guys had to have the vision for the content. And of course, it's all about content. But yeah, Prusha had that special genius for that. I think he got his background in radar in the Army or in the Navy. He was in the Navy, and he was doing radar and electronics then. Talk about an unassuming guy, low key, never wanted to be out front of anything. Oh, he hated that. He just wanted to make things work. That was his deal. Always wore a white short sleeve shirt with a blue tie and gray slacks. And I mean the same shirt, the same pants, the same tie, pretty much every day. But a great guy. He was in a weird position when he was here because he was in charge of a lot of stuff and really had to control this destiny, but wasn't so good, comfortable, or even cared to work with production people. And so while he had a couple of engineers that he was real close to, Roy Jorgensen would be one, Sam, I can't think of Sam's last name. It'll come later. Bill Genuine, Don Forseth. There were a handful of engineers, and they would work with Don, but when it came to production people, Jim Prusha had no time for that at all. Because I guess we were playing on his toy. You know, he had built this network, and we were coming in here as a bunch of snot-nosed kids and, you know, again, playing our trade on his instrument. Yet, he would put up a big blustery front of us being idiots and boneheads and everything. But when it came down to it, a heart as big as gold. And he loved every one of us, but he never told us. And he'd take you, if you got close to him, I remember one time, his relationship was such a love-hate thing where he really antagonized the production people. One of the production people, J.C. O'Neill was his name, he's now a cameraman for one of the networks, I think NBC in Los Angeles, was an Augie graduate. I met him at college too. But he was working here through university relations and then went out to California. He was working with Prusha here at the beginning before I started. And there was NORAL, whatever the organization would be for the legalization of marijuana, was on campus doing something. And JC went over with a $5 bill and made a donation to NORAL in Jim Prusha's name. Prusha's as right wing as they come. He was somewhere right of Attila the Hun. Bill Buckley was a centrist compared to Jim Prusha. Jim was way off to the right. And started getting these mailings from NORAL, you know, and that was kind of the way we'd get even with him. You know, we would do things like that to each other. It was that kind of a relationship. He sat me down one day, and when he first started to open up to me, and he said, looks like we were in the new building. We were here for one of the first times, and finally he and I sat down. And he said, you know, do you plan on being here? I said, I like this. Yeah, this is good work. It's good stuff. I can see a lot of stuff happening here. He said, well, you know, you probably will stay because none of the ones that are any good do. The good ones always get better jobs and leave here. So yeah, if you're mediocre, you'll probably stay. You know, just, you know. And I'm not saying that made me be good, but I said, okay, you know, I can at least be a platform unto my own self. And if I don't at least open that up and open that platform up for the people that work around me creatively, then I'm not doing my job at all. And that's really what I want to do here. So Prusha was out there on the edge, and I miss him.